I'm a big fan of what Nnamdi Kanu is talking about right now. But I have also seen a video of him before he traveled out, where the Igbos were kneeling down and prostrating before him as he moved. He looked to me like an authoritarian dictator. If they give him a country, is that how he's going to treat the Igbos? I saw that. You want me to show you the videos?
No. Let me finish my point here.
This is a discussion. It's not a typical interview. What I'm saying is that everybody's saying break it up. When I look at that video of Nnamdi Kanu, I know we're not ready for breakup. They love him, as you rightly say. He probably will win election hands down. But is that how he's going to treat his people? They were literally prostrated on the floor and was moving majestically among them. They were carrying it. Wait, sir. To me, that is not a democratic leader in the making. That is a despot. Maybe that's what the Igbos want. I'm not an Igbo, so I can't speak for them. But my point is, the leaders we have now, Kanu has not occupied any position yet. So maybe what I'm still guessing, I'm just prejudging him. But the leaders that we have right now, okay, in the constitution that they have right now, today, there is the autonomy for local governments. The governors are not doing it. They are not following the rule. They still treat the local government chairman as errand boys. There are many things in our constitution that is there right now that these our leaders are not following. What gives us the temerity or the confidence to think that, okay, if they now separate the countries, these leaders that have proved that they are lawless right now, that they have proved that they are profligate, that have proved that they are people who will siphon our commonwealth, even when they don't have this all-encompassing power. What is a guarantee that if they break it up, as we are saying, we are going to be in better hands? If there's create Oduduwa nation today, they're not going to make me president. It's going to be one of those guys that are going to be president. The parliament will make you president. The parliament will go make Isanashiwaju and all these guys that have the structure on ground that will hijack it. Have they proved that they are better? Are we not going to go into from fry pan to the fire? That is just a question still on this leadership team. So maybe what we really need is a concerted effort where everybody goes out and we vote out these bad leaders before we come to the issue of restructuring. I'm not saying we don't need restructuring. There's something morally offensive for oil to be found in the Niger Delta. And then the money just shared among everybody and there are poor people in that area. But anyway, I'm confronting the problem. Let me let you answer because you are looking at... So, yes, go ahead, sir.
There's so many things you've touched on there, but let me just say this. On the issue of self-determination and the aspirations and character of somebody like Nnamdi Kanu, which you touched on. Let me tell you that it is for the people of the East, Biafra or Southeast, whatever you call it, to determine who they want as their leader. And if they want somebody that's strong-willed and somebody like Nnamdi to be their leader, it is their choice. But let me also tell you this. You described him in very uncharitable terms there. I know this man. I've met this man.
Listen to me
carefully. I know him. I've met him. I've spoken to him. We've disagreed. And we have also agreed. And just as he's a lion, I'm also a lion. We're very, very, very close. And let me tell you, this man is somebody that loves his people with a passion and has risked everything and has lost so much simply because he stood up for his people. This is a man that was offered the world to give up this struggle. And he wants to do so. He is a man I have immense respect for. He has immense courage. And I commend him for that courage. And such a man cannot easily be dismissed. If his people are, you know, doing the sort of things you're saying, it's because they recognize something in him that you may not recognize. I see it. I've seen it. That is leadership. That is strength. That is an
100%, 100%.
Which they need because they have been subjugated and they have suffered probably more than any other people in this country. And he's given them hope and he's given them something to live for, which is why They literally worship him in many, many ways. And I can't take that from them, and I can't blame them for that. I see the same thing unfolding with somebody like Sunday Igbuhu in the Southwest. And I recognize this from the start. This is somebody, again, that has managed to tap into the psyche of the Yoruba nation, and he's the living manifestation, in my view, of Oduduwa Republic and Oduduwa himself. Courageous, strong, uncompromising, and clear thinking, and prepared to give up everything, probably including his life, for the struggle. These are very, very rare types of people. And they've risen up now, and they are the ones leading this thing. And for you to say that, well, we don't know what will happen, the type of quality of leader. Let me tell you, if for example,
I'm not even just talking about Nnamdi Kanu. Don't let's not dwell on what I just did, Nnamdi Kanu. I'm just saying our leadership generally. Okay, Nnamdi Kanu, like you rightly said, the Igbo citizens, what they want, they have a right to him. Yes. I'm talking about the leaders in office right now. Okay,
let me
have they shown us anything that they can run or do a Republic for?
You have said no. The leaders in office right now, let me assure you, yes, will probably play a very limited role. Let's use Oduduwa as an example. If we have Oduduwa Republic tomorrow, I can assure you those in office right now who have resisted it, and who don't want it, and who have fought against it, and who have even betrayed many of those that want it, will probably have a very limited role to play, because they are not separatists, they're integrationists. So what role are you going to play? You have a completely new set of leaders. Now, that's number one. Number two, you say maybe we should change...
He was about to kill me out. I take that thing about Nnamdi Kanu back before they kill me here. I'm just making a comment. No need to take violence, guys. All right, go ahead.
You said that maybe we should just try and change the leadership. Well, I challenge you. We've been trying to do this for many, many years. You get into the field and go and try and vote this government out, or get these people out, or even get PDP out. Get in there and try and do it and see what ends up happening. You see, what you have here is a situation that you literally can't change the leadership, because the two parties are basically one and the same. You have individuals that are very, very good. Shehi Makinde is another one. I've mentioned a few governors, that are good. Ayade is also good. Ogwai, Umahi, the Kogi governor, Buni, and Matawali. There are some good ones. But the truth of the matter is that the reality is that you're not going to change anything in this country politically unless you go all the way. And we are heading for the rocks now, because the system has failed all of us. Everybody's scared. Everybody's, even those that are in the pinnacle of power, they can see that we are on a sea in which there are icebergs waiting to sink our boat. And everybody's worried about how we're going to get through this. Now, I don't know what's going to happen, but I'll tell you this. I go back to it. The call for separatism is what is vogue now. The call for an independent nation in the Southwest, in the Southeast, and in parts of the South-South is what is vogue right now. Or the call to break the country into two. And what we have to do is to try to make people understand that we can still make Nigeria work if things are done right. If things are done right, we will do that. But let me also tell you this. If my people in the Southwest say, and there's a referendum, and say that they want to go, I will be the first to say, listen, I'm totally in support of that. And nobody can take that away from me or from them. But as long as we don't have that, as long as we don't have a referendum, that we must join hands with people from other parts of the country to try to create this whole issue of, a state where people are equal. Because you see, it's not even the corruption that people are worried about, as bad as it is. It's not that. What people are worried about is subjugation. Now, you take a man's land, you take a man's home, you take a man's wife, you take everything about him away, you take his language away, you take away his faith, you strip him bare, you shame him publicly, you turn him into nothing. And you kill his people. And you expect people to accept that. That is the fundamental issue we're facing right now in this country. And it's really happening. It's really happening. And that is what people are resisting. So nobody's talking about politics anymore. It's about survival now. It's an existential threat that we're facing. And excuse me if I upset people by talking like this in very, very, harsh and hot terms. But I'm fed up with political correctness. And I believe that many of us have improved right now, that we're on a wrong course, and we need to work together to chart a better course so that we have peace in our country. And that's what we need to do. Peace is the quest today. Peace Peace first.
All right. So let's solve our problems. Let's move the debate again. For those of you watching at home, you are watching Chief FFK on the hot seat with me tonight. If you have ever watched Naija Lives Matter show, you know it's not an interview.
Can I just add this? Sorry to what I was saying. You see,
yes.
The key to understanding is you must be a warrior, not a warrior. A warrior, a fighter, not somebody that just sits back at home and worries all the time. I'm so scared of tomorrow. I don't know what's going to happen. There are too many warriors in Nigeria. We need fighters. We need warriors. People that will and stand firm for what is right, no matter what. That is what we need. And until we get that, nothing is going to change.
Fair.